Hello friends and welcome to my channel. As an educator, are you struggling to create clear guidelines for how students can or cannot use AI tools in their studies? If you are, stay tuned as we dive into effective strategies for crafting statements around students' use of AI tools in their studies. So why is it important to produce a clear statement? Well, generative artificial intelligence tools are becoming easily accessible to a wide audience. And as educators, we must make sure that our students understand when and how they can use these AI tools in their studies. To do this, a set of clear statements are required so that staff and students know what is and is not permissible in terms of AI use. In this video, I'm going to use a fictional module to outline how you can create a set of example statements. To begin with, state clearly whether AI use is or is not allowed. Let's start with a statement where AI use is not allowed. You can create the following type of statement in your module materials, but before doing so, make sure to check to see if a statement already exists within your institution. The examples I'm going to use are based on existing guidance from my own institution, and I'll tell you how you can access these later on in the video. So, if you decide that AI tools are not allowed, I would suggest guidance based on something along the lines of: within this module, the use of artificial intelligence tools like ChatGPT, Gemini, Copilot or similar is not allowed in any activities. This makes it clear that no AI can be used in any aspect of the module studies. Then I would add something along the lines of: this restriction applies to all assignments and assessments contributing to your overall module mark. So in this section, it makes clear that no AI can be used in these activities. Then I would add, using AI in your assignments and assessments for this module will result in a breach of the university's codes of academic integrity, potentially impacting your future academic studies. Here, make sure you include a link to your institution's codes of practice in relation to academic integrity processes. So, these types of statements will make it clear to staff and students where they stand in relation to AI use in their studies. Where AI use is allowed, use statements need to be a little more involved. Let's begin with the process of learning. Here you need to be clear about the areas students can use AI in your module. You can put something like the following statement: in this module, you can use generative AI to develop learning. You can use AI in the following activities: exploring and honing your ideas through research, conducting information retrieval or background investigations, creating an outline to structure or summarize your ideas, fine-tuning research questions, verifying spelling and grammar accuracy. Now, this type of statement should help set the boundaries of activities that are and are not allowed in the module. To help you explore how you can design these activities, have a look at a recent video I made about using AI in the classroom using the PEAR framework. When it comes to assessment, again, a clear statement about what is and is not allowed is needed. I would start by stating, you cannot submit any work produced by an AI tool as your original work. If you use material generated by an AI program, it must be cited, the same as other referenced materials. This makes it clear that any AI-generated work must be referenced. Additionally, alongside your assignment, you must provide a commentary explaining the role of generative AI in creating your submission. What you can do here is ask that the students provide something like an appendix outlining the way they've used AI and how it has influenced their work. At the end of this video, I'll provide a link to another video I've produced showing how you can ask students to create a document for this exact purpose. Finally, if students have not used AI, in your statement you can add, make a clear statement if you have not used AI tools. This statement makes clear that the student has not used AI in any of their assessment work. I hope this short video has helped you consider how you can craft effective statements for using AI tools in learning and assessment activities. As I mentioned earlier, before writing your own statements, check whether your institution has already created ones that you can draw upon. I've drawn on examples in this video from my own institution and put a link in the section below. Like most issues around AI in education, this page will be updated on a regular basis. The skills and knowledge required to use AI tools ethically are going to be helpful for students in the future, particularly when they navigate their future work environments. I've created a set of videos here that you can access using this link to help you explore these areas further. Thank you for joining me today. I would be interested in hearing your views. Please do take some time to leave a comment below. If you found this video useful, please make sure you like the video and consider subscribing to my channel. I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye.